But whoever does not believe stands condemned already, because he has not believed in the name of God, one and only Son, which is Jesus Christ, who died upon Calvary's cross for our sins. In John 10:10, it says, the thief comes only to steal, kill, and destroy. It says, God has come that they may have life and have it to be fulfilled. And then Jesus answered and said, I am the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And you will be my witness in Jerusalem, and in all of Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. And Peter said, tell everyone, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, and forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Repent then and turn to God, so that your sins may be wiped out. That time for refreshing may come from the Lord. Salvation is found in no one else. For there is no other name under heaven given to men by which we must be saved. They replied, believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, you and your household. As it is written, there is no one righteous, not even one. For all have sinned and fell short of the glory of God.
I wonder what the scariest thing on Halloween would be. At 10 out of 10, people die. And everybody will die. You'll live somewhere for eternity, though.
But the gift of God is eternal life in Jesus Christ our Lord. But if you confess by mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is what your heart that you believe and are justified. And it is with your mouth that you confess and are saved. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Consequently, faith comes from hearing the message. And the message is hearing through the word of Christ. For he said, in the time of my favor, I hear you. And in the days of salvation, I help you. I will tell you how is the time of God's favor. Now is the day of salvation. For it is by the grace you have been saved, through faith. And this not from yourself. It is the gift of God. Not by words, so that no one can boast. You believe that there is one God, good. Even the demons believe that there was one God. And they shudder. Before God exalts him to the highest place, gave him the name that is above every name. That is the name of Jesus. Every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess Jesus Christ as Lord, to the glory of our God the Father. And I write these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, that you may know that you have eternal life. How shall we escape if we ignore such a great salvation? This salvation, which was first announced by the Lord, was confirmed to us by those who heard him. In fact, the law requires that nearly everything be cleansed with by faith judgment. That is one appointment that we cannot get by with. Let us not give up meeting together, as some are in habit of doing, but let us encourage one another, and all the more as you see the days approaching. We are all like sheep. We have gone astray. Each of us has turned to his own way, and the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of all of us. Then he said to his disciples, the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few. Ask the Lord of the harvest before to send out workers into the harvest field. But what about you, he asked. Why did you say I am? And Simon Peter answered him, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus came to them and said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always, to the end, very end of the age. Then he said to them all, if anyone would come after me, he must first deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save what was lost. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, and the Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and the only, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. In response, Jesus declares, I tell you the truth, no one can see the kingdom of God unless he is born again. And God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever shall believe in him shall not perish but have everlasting life. And yes, folks, the days are coming short. If we follow the book of Revelation, we'll find that we're getting closer to the end of the book of Revelation than we are the beginning. And today, if you're lost and you're without knowing of God and how Jesus died upon the cross for our sins, then you need to repent. You need to be right with God. Because if you're not, you're definitely... The Bible says definitely we're going to burn in hell. If we're not saved, if we don't confess by our mouths and open our hearts and let Jesus in, we will burn in hell. The Bible says that. So I would suggest anybody that's lost in this world, anybody that don't know God, find you a church. Or drop to your knees right now. Drop to your knees right now and repent and say the repenter's prayer.